Hello, my friends. Finally, the snow has arrived, and so it's the perfect day for bushcraft. Actually, it's late afternoon. I won't have much light, daylight, with me. But anyway, I wanted to go and enjoy the snow. Right now it's coming down really very well and also my dog is happy. When you go out with the snow, you have to know exactly where you are going, because it's not so easy to follow the path, especially when it's coming down so well. It's easy to let your footprints will fade out, will be covered with the snow. So if you are not if you don't know very well the path, you can get lost in the storm. And now I'm following the footstep of my dog. He never get lost. I hope that this wind won't bother me at the camp, otherwise I will have to choose another location, but we will see. As I said in another video, I don't like to have a camp too much organized for this reason, because I like to have an open option to choose where I want to stay. So I prefer to take everything I need, or at least the strictly necessary stuff with me, instead of leaving that at the camp, even if many camps that I have won't be found by anyone anyway. But as I said, for me, it's not a good option. You can hear the church, but I can't see it. The storm has stopped for a while, and in this time I can get some of these vines that can be useful in this environment to start the fire. I just have to be careful not to make all the snow fall down. Given that I want to make a good tea, and everything, as you can see, is really full of snow, the first thing to do to start a fire after having taken those vines is to find a good dead standing log and cut it and split to take the inner part. So let's do it. This is my chair. And I would like to put the fire exactly in this place. Eventually I can put my poncho over me in a configuration between these two trees here. I will bridge them with a paracord, and eventually I will put first I want to start my fire, if I can do it. This piece right here is what we need. This. This is where I will put my fire. When the base of your log is not perfectly flat, it's a good habit to batoon it not here the blade, but exactly where is the log. You see, at least the first, because otherwise it will slip away. Let me show you. If you batoon it like this, the log will slip away, while if you batoon it here, where the log is, for the first batoon, then you can go straight and have a pencil size stick completely dry. Use my poncho to collect the dry wood. Now we will make a pile of feathers. This is one of
the most important steps to do if you want to start a fire in the rain or in the snow. A good pile of feathers or some feather sticks is what you need. Let's try not to try to cover a bit. Okay, fair amount of feathers. Now we cover them a bit. We make some other pencil size sticks. See, using the tip of your knife, you can make the stick the size you want. These two logs, for example, could be of good use for the fire. You can put these two in a cross way. Like this. Hope you can see it because the conditions are not very good, but anyway, this is the usual method that I use. This dry stuff is really wet, but I'm sure that it will take the flame with the char cloth anyway. Trying to make everything quickly because I want to do it while it's not snowing too much. Okay, should be good enough. Now it's time for the chocolate. In these cases I prefer to use a bigger piece of chocolate. See, we put this inside like this, put away the knife. Now we just blow trying to find a good angle so you can see it. Now it's the time for the feathers, the pile of feathers, which we put exactly on the top of it. And then start with the sticks. First the dry one, of course, and then all the others. I don't I can see if you can see it very well, but I hope so. Okay, now that the fire is up and going, I'm warming up a bit, because we are really cold here, I will cut some other pieces of this log and split it to put inside the fire. With the rest. This is much better with a good fire. It's all another planet. Okay. Now let's boil some water and make a good cup of tea. Dealing with the snow is really important that when you are dealing with the snow, as I was saying, it's really important that you put everything inside your pocket. Never leave anything around. I'm talking for experience. You know, guys, I really love the wood stoves, and they are really useful, especially in the summer. But for me, nothing beats a good fire, the warmth of it, and also the company of it, for me at least. Sorry for that little branch. But I don't like to cut it, just to shoot the video. Now, I'm like a king here. Almost boiling the water. I couldn't say that it's a beautiful day, but it really is a beautiful day to stay outside. It will be because I like very much the snow, and I really love this environment. This is the best for me. I won't have to wait long for it to cool down. I really love the poncho because you can use it for many purposes. Nothing can beat good tea, good hot tea or coffee in the snow.
next to the fire, for me at least. Cheers, my friends. I just wanted to share with you a few moments in the late afternoon, given that we had this beautiful snow all around. I wanted to spend some moments outside in a storm. Getting a bit late, but here with next to my fire, I stay very well. In a survival situation, making a fire and try to cover yourself is the only option. Is the only option to survive. In a weather like this, if you can do this and also find a good cover, you see that I've used this. Tree as a shield. If I have some parkour, I can put a piece of parkour there and there to make a cover, so I will stay warm. And even if I won't sleep very well, I can survive. Even if, as I always think, the real problem in an environment like this is not surviving the night, because if you can do this, you can survive. It's surviving, not starving, because finding the food in this condition is really, really difficult. Believe me, guys. This is the most difficult part of the survival situation. See you soon, my friends. Take care. Bye-bye.